Hello, Million Dollar Babe. So today we're talking about making millions versus being a millionaire. So this is really, really obvious to me now, but it wasn't before. And I've actually never discussed this here, so I thought it would be really fun to dive into this topic. So back in the day, I used to think that you would be a millionaire when you were making millions of dollars. Makes sense, right? Most of us, I think this. But recently, I have met so many entrepreneurs that make seven figures in their business, but they are nowhere close to being millionaires. In fact, they do not even have a six-figure net worth. They're living client to client. So meaning that they are one client away from basically being in the same boat as someone that's paycheck to paycheck. And this was quite surprising for me, right? So you guys who have been following, you know, my husband and I, like our journey, we made our first million on 1 6-figure salary with just smart money management, right? Like investing and living below your means and all of that yummy stuff. But in the last 5 years, as I launched my business, I really just started using the law of attraction, which I was already using, but really using it on a larger scale, and then combined with actual practical money management, money literacy skills, we've been able to you know, grow and grow and grow and grow our wealth many, many times over. So one of the things that I think people get into this money block is that they think that they will become a millionaire when they have more money. And so they are in this state where they have to like outchase their spending. But if you are making $1 million and spending $1 million, if you made 2 million, you would still be leaking a lot of money, right? You would never be able to catch up, basically. So some of the conversations that I had with these women that were making seven figures, which again, that's amazing. Obviously, they've worked really, really hard to get here. But they're in that state where there's a couple things going on. One, they think that when they make more money, more than $1 million a year, then they will save. But some of these women already make more than $1 million and they're still client to client. So what's going on? They don't know financial literacy, meaning they don't know what to do with that money once that money comes to them. They don't know how to invest it, they don't know how to manage it, and they still have those subconscious self-sabotage things going on where they have to spend the money. Like, it's like the money makes them really uncomfortable. I have seen these women just have all of these obnoxious business expenses that absolutely make no sense because they're actually not very profitable, but they're like, this is what you need to do to make money. And so they're making all this money and they're leaking all this money and they're exhausted, but they have to out hustle, they have to keep running. So that's what I think is the number one thing. Number two is that they've got other people managing a lot of stuff for them, right? If you are someone that's having someone else manage your money and you are not intimate with your money, I have a wake-up call for you, because that's how a lot of lottery winners, female celebrities, even male celebrities, that's how they actually go broke despite having millions of dollars. Watch my 5 Female Millionaire Habits video, which I will link in the description box below, to learn the actual habits of women that have money, meaning they've made it and then they've kept it and invested it and have it grow. The number one thing, the third thing is that I think that these women don't know how to invest their money and have their money work for them. So I've shared with you this before, that I don't spend money that I have earned, right? So if I've traded my energy and time for this money, that money gets reinvested. I spend the dividends and the investment money and the portfolio money and the passive income money. So that the original money that came in that I exchanged my time for, my energy for, my most precious resource and asset, that money is a part of my team, okay? That money is in my flow. That money is a part of my portfolio. I'm not going to exchange my precious energy for money and then let that go. That's family, right? That's a part of me. And so that money stays. That money becomes a part of my team, my portfolio, and it keeps producing babies. And that's the money that I then spend. So I just wanted to kind of shed light to the fact that making millions is actually not going to make you a millionaire, not necessarily. What you need to do is start setting it up, the systems and the money blocks, and releasing the shame and the conditioning, doing the money inner work now, and then you can become a millionaire even if you don't make millions of dollars, okay? So those two things are not necessarily one in the same. So if you wanna learn more, join my free 3-day money, raise your money mojo challenge, which is happening on my Million Dollar Babe email community. Become a BFF with me via email. The link is in the description box. It's also at The Universe Grew, my website, theuniversegrew.com, and sign up, and then you get some emails to prime you for the challenge. And then in 6 days, 7 days, I think the challenge starts. So I'm super excited to have you as part of my email BFF, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.